Hello, I'm Paul Zajacek, founder of Elastic Steel Method of Athletic Conditioning. Today I'm going to talk about a common question that comes up in the Warrior Strategy Seminar and other places, YouTube videos. I say keep your hands up and I give you various ways to keep the hands up. But I always say that if your hands are down, as long as you know that your hands are down, as long as you know where your hands are, it's okay. Sometimes it serves a purpose to drop your hands. And sometimes I get questions where people say, how can you say that? Why would you say that you should drop your hands? Today I'm going to give you three different reasons why you should drop your hands, of course, under specific conditions. Just like in warrior strategy, I'm going to compare fighting to military formation to give you an example of why you should drop your hands, and you will see how that works. Case number one, you just moved out of range. You moved out of range, you're moving around. You're moving around, you don't have to keep your hands up here. If you know for sure your opponent is out of range, you do not have to waste your energy, keep your hands up here, keep your head down, because your opponent is out of range. If we look at ancient Sparta, ancient Rome, the warriors were shoulder to shoulder, shield to shield. Now, they fought that way. However, once the fight was over, the commanders didn't say, okay, stand right there, stand in formation, matter of fact, sleep right there, matter of fact, sleep in formation, matter of fact, stay that way, don't even lie down, stay in formation. No, the fight is over, or there's a break between fighting, you break the formation. Fighting starts again, you form the formation again. You're in range, your hands come up. You're out of range, you drop your hands. Case number two, your opponent likes to do something. He likes to use that three right hand. Okay, you know he's looking for this. He's looking for you to drop the hand. Drop that left hand. As long as you prepare that he's going to throw that right hand, and you know what you're going to do once he saw it, whatever you're going to do, you prepare it, you can drop it. Same thing in military. Somebody likes flanking maneuvers, open that flank, send that line. But be prepared that once they go through that line, you'll do something else. Maybe you'll encircle them. Give them what they want, let them through, and then attack them. As long as you prepare it, dropping those defenses is a good idea. Reason number three, condition your opponent to expect something and then break it. For example, you come in with your hands up, throw the kick, drop the hands, come out. Come in with your hands up, throw the kick, drop the hands, come out. Come in once again with your hands up, throw the kick, drop the hands. Now your opponent is going to expect for you to move back. He's not even going to move back himself, because why would he? You moving back. This time, drop the hands, fake going back, throw the kick with your hands down. Same thing in military. Always tell the soldiers, keep the formation, no matter what. Don't break the formation, shoulder to shoulder, shield to shield. Never break the formation. Do you know why that is? Nobody wants to see an enemy behind you or an enemy on the side of you. So if I see a little break there and a little break there and I'm a soldier and they come in this way, the formation is broken, I'm going to turn and run. So your opponent might expect that. If they see a broken formation, they might expect you to run. If they don't, condition them. Send a small army, let the formation be broken, let them run. Another small army, let the formation be broken, let them run. Third time, send the army, let the formation be broken. Now they're going to expect you to run. You won't. They're going to be caught by surprise. Those are three reasons why you should not always keep your hands up when you know what you're doing. Some of the examples were taken from the Warrior Strategy online seminar. Thank you for watching.